guys, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video, let's see what is adaptive equalizer in wireless systems. It is also used in digital communication where we need to reduce the noise. So before understanding what is adaptive equalizer, let's understand what is the process of equalization or why it is basically used. So equalizer is mainly used in order to reduce or in order to eliminate the ISI, which is called as the inter-symbol interference, and also it is also need to reduce the additive noise which gets added as and when time progresses. So for that we have these systems called as equalizers. Now these systems are basically kept at the receiver side. So you have a transmitter as well as a receiver. So these equalizers are some kind of systems which are capable in order to reduce some of the coefficients which cause the delay, and also to extend the available bandwidth for the signal for a digital transmission. Now these equalizers are categorized into n number of types. Now for our systems, which is time varying, since we have a channel for every system, like it has to be transmitted through a channel. So these channels usually are of in a time varying manner, and so we need to have a system or an equalizer which is in a known fashion or which varies according with the time. So for that we have this adaptive equalizer which just varies with the time and which functions in a proper way. So equalizers are basically functioned in this block diagram. So before that, let's understand how this noise gets generated or how this additive noise gets added into the signal. So basically we have a 4 level pulse amplitude modulation sequence. So it's a proper signal. So it is XT. So that signal, when we just input it to the channel containing the impulse response, that is HT, then we get a sample rate. So this step just necessarily produces the sampling. So sampling is just dividing all the signals into equal intervals with a equal factor or proportion. Next, this sample is just added, or it is just mixed with a combiner, and some noise signal, that is NT, is added to it, and so you get a signal which is in this way, that is a distorted signal that you get as RT. Now this particular functionality we need to implement in a system, like before the sending of the original output, we need to produce it in the receiver. So this equalizer is necessarily put at the receiver end. So this is a block diagram of how the adaptive equalizer basically works. So let's understand the working as well as the two modes which are there, which are followed in the adaptive equalizer. So to begin with, we have this received signal. So received signal could be this RT or some any other T, a random signal. We have this very first block, that is a receive filter. So this receive signal is fed to this receives filter, and so this receive filter is not a matching filter, that you need to understand. Means it does not matches with the originally preoccupied signals with it, and it just not does the forwarding of the signals, but instead since it is not aware of the channel impulse response which is generated, that is HT, it is a low pass filter that we use. Now this low pass filter just basically rejects or eliminates all of the noise which are contained in the received signal. So it's basically simple. You have a received signal something like this, which is distorted with noise. You input it to the receive filter, it will just eliminate all the outliers which are there, and then it forwards on to the next step. Now output of this receive filter is sampled at a symbol rate. So that symbol rate could be 2 times of the original symbol rate, or it could be a normal symbol rate. Then the sampled signal, which is in a discrete time shared manner, is applied to a adaptive transversal filter equalizer. So this adaptive equalizer, it has its name as adaptive transversal filter equalizer, means it transverses over a particular time. So and so it needs to be a discrete time filter. So it accordingly with the time, it just filters all the signals. Now this objective mainly is to adjust all the coefficients which are there, like you have many functionalities or many delays which will be there in this signal or in this process before it starts. So pre-processing activity involves many kind of other parameters or other AWGN networks, like additive white Gaussian noise will be there. So that all things or that all coefficients will be adapted in order to tackle or eliminate the noise and as well as the ISI, that is inter-symbol interference. Now this adaptation of equalizer is driven by an error signal. So after this, after processing of this adaptive equalizer, you get an error signal that is called as a ET, that is prediction error. Now after this you have two basic modes in which adaptive equalizer works. So the very first mode is the decision directed mode, or called as the tracking mode. So in this, whatever decisions are taken are solely taken by the receiver, which is used to generate the error signal. And so we just do not prefer this, or it's not suitable because of its slow tracking activity. Now since this is the initial phase or initial activity at this process or at this stage, we do not go with the slow tracking since it's time consuming. And so we employ the second type of mode, that is we have the training mode, which is used to make the equalizer suitable according to the environment. That's the name, it's called as the adaptive equalizer, adaptive to the situations. So in this, whatever decisions or whatever signals you get, the transmitter generates a data symbol which is known to the receiver. So it's already agreed between the transmitter and the receiver, means they know like what data symbol they are going to encounter. So the receiver then substitutes this symbol in place of the slicer output. So here when you go or surpass the slicer, you have a signal which will contain all the outliers eliminated. So that will be certain kind of signal which will be replaced by this data symbol known between the receiver and the transmitter. Now once they agree upon a certain time, like the receiver and transmitter will agree like after so much time we need to replace the original signal or put back the data signal. So once an agreed time or the signal time elapses, the slicer output is then substituted back and the actual data transmission commences. So after this process, what we have a high bandwidth channel for faster data transmission, and it's mainly used for mobile radio communication. So well, that was all regarding the adaptive equalizer in wireless digital communication. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you got here, you watching this video, please do like, share, comment, and if you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching this video.